When we think about recent history and how far humans have come in such a short time, it can be really difficult to understand how our ancient ancestors were able to create such large, diverse cultures all around the world. Though it isn't only the amazing buildings and inventions that completely blow us away, but the underlying details about how these cultures survived, lived, and thrived for so long without all of the modern medicines we have today. Though ancient cultures may have had access to information that has since been lost to time. In fact, some of these civilizations may have had highly advanced knowledge about the human body and medical science that we're still working to understand all these years later. These discoveries and inventions helped these civilizations to treat and cure diseases and sickness of all kinds. And only recently have we begun to discover the knowledge behind these incredible medications. Today, we'll take a look at a few of the most mysterious discoveries that researchers have found. But before we get started, be sure to hit that like button and ring the notification bell for more videos. Rose root. Herbal teas and supplements are gradually becoming popular again, but it seems like these treatments were even more popular in ancient times than they are today. If you live in Asia or Europe and are looking for a great remedy for the common cold, it wouldn't be too unordinary to have someone recommend rose root tea. This tea is grown and most consumed in parts of Europe and Asia, and has been used for thousands of years. It's one of the most popular folk medicines that can still be found today. But people used to use it to treat all sorts of things, from colds to depression, to physical weakness, to tuberculosis. The list goes on and on. In places like Siberia, some people even referred to it as the golden root because it was so valuable and was used to treat virtually everything. Some people from the ancient time periods claim that this root would have basically been the key to a long, prosperous life. The root would help elderly people keep their memory, make them more receptive to new ideas, and even help with concentration. According to history that has been found all over the world, Greeks, Vikings, and even white people of America used this root to treat all sorts of things. It has recently been discovered that the ancient Chinese would carry out expeditions, traveling as far as Siberia, to find this mystical plant and bring it back to their citizens. At the time, rose root was considered one of the most effective herbal remedies in the world. However, somewhere along the way, the recipe for many of these medicines that used rose root was lost. In modern times, the plant was almost completely forgotten about in the Western world. It would only be a few decades ago that researchers would rediscover this incredible plant, and they're now researching its uses more intently than ever before. So far, their findings have been incredible. Scientists say that our ancestors knew far more about rose root than we ever did. They say that the plant has proven benefits for treating depression and working as a nootropic. Some scientists say that the root can help balance neurochemistry and improve both cognition and well-being. Though we have to make sure you guys understand, this video is not intended to be medical advice. Do not take any of the supplements or treatments in the video without first talking to a doctor. I'd hate for anyone to have some sort of a reaction or make a poor decision about their health based on this video. Everything we talk about is for informational purposes only and to help tell the history of ancient humans. Be sure to do your own research and talk with a proper medical advisor before making any rash decisions. Antidepressants in Turkish Lake. Researchers in 2013 and 2015 were excavating an area near a large lake in Turkey. The lake is about 23 kilometers from the remains of an ancient settlement known as Bathonia, which would nowadays be close to Istanbul. The researchers worked for over 2 years to excavate the area to learn more about the humans that would have lived there hundreds or thousands of years ago. While searching around the lake, they found at least 700 ceramic vials, though many of them were broken. Archaeologists did their best to piece the vials back together, while scientists took samples of the contents to find out what would have been stored in the vials. We've known that this settlement was recognized worldwide for having some of the best healthcare available. These guys knew what they were doing when it came to medical science, and they had some of the most sophisticated medicines that have ever been created, some of which may still be used today. As they took samples of the contents of the vials, they learned that several of them contained medications like methadone and phenanthrene. We don't know for sure, but it seems like the people who once lived here could have been using these chemicals to treat depression. Though nowadays we understand that both of these chemicals can be incredibly harmful to humans, so stay away from them, kids. Scientists also claim that they could have been used to treat certain types of pain and heart disease, though again, they should not even be considered in the modern world. In 2011, a group of researchers excavated a series of graves and uncovered about 70 bodies. If you thought a depression and pain treatment was incredible, brace yourself for this one. They found out that one of the bodies had been operated on, and a portion of his skull had been removed during surgery. Brain surgery is an incredibly difficult science these days, but it seems like these people were carrying out basic brain surgery operations all those years ago. What's even more insane is that brain surgery is ridiculously painful, and some people could die purely from the pain or from infection. However, this man lived for many years after the surgery was performed. This means that the surgery was likely a success, but at the very least, they were able to treat him well enough to prevent infection or serious pain, meaning they likely had some early form of sedative and antibacterial treatment. We don't know for sure how this operation was successful, but the only explanation seems to suggest that early humans had an insane understanding of medical science and were able to carry out all sorts of complicated operations. 9th century eye ointment. We don't know for sure who wrote the book titled Bald's Pharmacopoeia. We also don't know when it was written. What we do know is that the book contains countless recipes for herbal remedies that can treat all sorts of common ailments that would have plagued people from this time period. By all means, this was likely one of the most valuable books and could have been used by doctors around the country to help bring patients back from the brink. The book appears to have been written sometime in the 9th century, but it would be 2015 before modern scientists would put the book to the test and try out one of its many recipes for medications. A team of microbiologists from Nottingham University decided to create a recipe from the book that would have been used to treat infections from barley grains or other bacteria. The mixture required white wine, leek, garlic, and ox bile. It needed to be placed in a copper pot and stirred constantly for several days. After this, the mixture was to be removed and squeezed out and filtered using a cloth. The scientists followed the steps exactly as they were written, and after 9 days, the ointment was ready to be tested. Before now, the ointment had probably not been made for several thousand years, but now in 2015, the ointment was going to be tested out for the first time when the researchers put the ointment up against some of the world's worst bacterial strains. They learned that it was incredibly effective. One of the most devastating bacteria they used it against was the deadly MRSA bacteria that infects countless people every year. This bacteria can often be harmless, but if it gets out of hand, it can lead to all sorts of problems in the body and eventually cause death. This is especially true for people that may have lung diseases such as cystic fibrosis. When the scientists looked over the results, they found that this medieval ointment was over 90% effective at eliminating MRSA. They concluded that it was equally effective to vancomycin, which is the only known antibiotic that's effective against the bacteria. This opened up so many doors for future treatments, but obviously more testing is required before they can turn this concoction into a modern medication. The strange thing is that the researchers also tested each of the individual ingredients against MRSA, but found that they did nothing. The only way they worked to eliminate the bacteria is when they were combined together and mixed according to the instructions. So how is it that these ancient humans had such a high level of medical knowledge to know how to combine all of these chemicals to make them the most effective? We may never know. Artemisinin. This is one of the more complicated cases that stem from ancient China. In 2015, a scientist named Tu Youyou was granted a Nobel Prize after she was able to isolate artemisinin from mugwort. This type of treatment had been used for thousands of years in ancient China and was found to be extremely effective at fighting off tuberculosis. Up until this point, we had no idea how the ancient humans would have defended themselves from this terrible illness. But Dr. Tu had finally proven what we had all been curious about. After she was given the prize, she was asked to join a government program known as Project 523. This project would examine other ancient Chinese medications that had been in use for more than 2,000 years and help determine why they were so effective at treating various conditions and illnesses. We don't know for sure how our ancestors were able to harness the power of these plants, bacteria, and other organisms and use them to fight off illnesses. For example, artemisinin is proven to be amazing at fighting off malaria as well. But it makes no sense how the ancient Chinese would have known this without all of the inventions, devices, and tools we have in modern science. The best guess we can come up with is that the ancient humans would have simply tried combining all sorts of different things until they found a mixture that actually worked. We can't say this for sure, but nothing else makes sense. When scientists tested artemisinin against tuberculosis, they found that it completely deactivates the defense mechanisms of the illness. This allows our bodies to fight it off easily and quickly. This would also dramatically reduce how long treatment would take. Most times, tuberculosis takes up to 6 months to fight off, but it seems like this newfound treatment could help fight the illness away in just a few days or weeks. Clearly, ancient civilizations knew a lot more about medical science than we like to give them credit for. By all means, these guys clearly had access to some advanced knowledge that we've lost as time goes on. Or, at the very least, they had some amazing guessing skills when it comes to mixing random things together to create highly effective medicines. The truth is, we're probably only scratching the surface of what remedies there are out there for all sorts of illnesses and diseases, though these treatments may have simply been lost to time. In reality, our ancestors may be able to teach us a whole lot more than we would be able to teach them. Let us know what you think about this. How did these guys know how to create such complicated treatments for these ailments? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to hit that like button and ring the notification bell for more videos.